Hi, this is Rob. I'm going to show you how to make a photo slideshow on your smartphone using the Quik app. First, you need to download the Quik app. It is available for both iOS and Android. I'm using an Android phone, the LG G5 smartphone. This is what the Quik app looks like on the Google Play Store. The Quik app is made by GoPro, but you do not need a GoPro to use this app. The description also states that this is a video editor, but it's not a traditional video editor. It is more like an automatic slideshow creator where you can mix photos and short video clips to make a video slideshow. You can select a theme, add text to each photo, choose the duration length of the finished video slideshow, choose the music, and other options that I will cover in this video. Once the app is installed, open it. Go to the upper right and tap on this settings icon. The finished video slideshow will be rendered at a resolution of 720p HD, but if you want a 1080p HD video, then select it here. After you select 1080p, you can then select Pro Quality Video here. When you select this Pro Quality option, it will give you this warning that Pro Quality will result in bigger files and slower saving and uploading. That is because when you choose Pro Quality, it doubles the video bitrate from 8 megabits per second to 16 megabits per second. I'm going to set my option back to 720p. Going down, there are no other important options to choose. Going back to the home screen of the Quik app, tap on the Create a New Video button. First step to create a slideshow is determine where you want to select your photos from. Across the top you see Gallery, which is the media gallery on your smartphone. Albums. Albums are the different media files on your smartphone. Google Photos. Choose photos from your Google Photos stream or from one of your Google Photos albums. Connect with Dropbox. GoPro Recent. GoPro Plus. GoPro Plus is a paid monthly cloud service where one can store their GoPro videos and photos. GoPro Quik Key, which is a GoPro micro SD card reader. I'm going to go back to Gallery, the image gallery on my Android phone, and choose some recent photos that I took in Valencia, Spain. You can choose up to 75 photos or a combination of 75 photos and video clips for the slideshow. If you want to view one of the photos more clearly, long press on it. Tap on it to make it go back. Now tap on the photos you want in your slideshow. When you have chosen all the photos you want, tap on this check mark in the lower right to go to the next step. In this step, we will add a title for our video slideshow. I will call this Valencia. Press the Continue button. Here near the bottom are four different icons. This is where you can make changes to the slideshow. But first, you can view the automated slideshow. And if you like it, you do not need to make any changes. This icon here is video style, and there are many different styles to play with and decide which one you want to use. As you select a different style, it will play through the entire slideshow so you can determine if this is the style you want to use. I'm not going to show all the different styles. This is the music icon. You change the music used in the slideshow here. I'll tap on the more music. On top, you can see their picks for that style that you are currently using. So you have a lot of different choices of music. I will go back to the original music that I had and tap on this blue circle with the check mark inside of it. This icon is where you can add text to a photo, rotate a photo, delete a photo, or add a photo from your gallery. You can also rearrange the photos in the slideshow. To change a position of a photo, Just drag the photo where you want it. When you select a photo, you will see that pencil over the photo. Tap on the photo again, then you have some additional editing options that pop up that you can apply to that photo. I'm going to add a caption to this photo by tapping on this Add Text icon. Type train station, then tap the green bar. You can also add a slide that has text only. Tap on the Edit Text, then tap on this title. Type the text you want. I will type Day 2. Tap the green bar. Tap this other green bar below. Now move the text only slide to where you want it. I'm going to remove it by tapping this remove icon. You can add additional photos to Slideshow here by tapping on this blue icon in the upper right. It takes you back to your gallery where you can choose additional photos. I'm going to add this photo here by tapping on it, then tap here on this icon on the bottom right. This focus icon here, I'm not sure what it does, but you can select the focus point of the photo by moving this to the spot that you want to be in focus. I don't know. This duration. You can change the duration of the slideshow. I will slide it to a max and tap on the green bar. The cinema icon. Right now our aspect ratio of our video slideshow is 16:9. That is what the cinema means. Tap on it, and now the aspect ratio of the slideshow is square. You may want this square aspect ratio if you plan on sharing this slideshow on Instagram. I'm going to change it back to cinema by tapping on it. Music start. This icon is where you can change the start time when the music begins to play. Filters. You can apply a filter to the slideshow. You have a choice of 10 different filters. Font. You have a choice between two different font styles for your text. Palette. Palette lets you choose the colors of the text-only slides. Outro. Outro is a portion of music at the end of the slideshow. You can activate it or deactivate it. Okay, when you're finished adjusting the slideshow, it's time to save it and share it. Tap on this icon here to save and share it. The options are Share Link, Save Without Sharing, and Send File. When you press the Share Link, app starts processing the slideshow, and then we'll upload the slideshow to the GoPro Quik app server. You'll be sharing a link to that slideshow on the GoPro site. Your video is private and encrypted, and it cannot be found via Google search. When the slideshow is finished processing, this window pops up, and then you choose where you want to share the link to the video. I will email the link. After you share the link, we are taken to this part of the app. This is where all the slideshows that you have created will be listed. Right now I only have this one. When you tap on this three-dot icon here, this window pops up. The send file here is where you can actually send a copy of the video, not just a link to the video. The rename is where you can change the title of the slideshow. The delete, you can delete this slideshow, but if you delete the slideshow here, it will also delete the slideshow from the shared link on the GoPro Quik app server. Duplicate and edit. This is where you can make a copy of this slideshow and then go in and do edits so that you can have a different version of the slideshow. This share video icon will share a link to the video. This plus icon is where you can start a completely new project. I want to show you what the shared link looks like when you send it to someone and they click on it. They can play it, share it to Facebook, Twitter, or even download the video. Okay, that is it. That is how to make a photo slideshow with the GoPro Quik app on your smartphone. Next is the photo slideshow that I created. If you like this how-to video, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to this channel.
Stuck in nostalgia like me.